All right, so here we go with the G shape, and we're going to play the big S5L, and what's S5L? Right there, 6-7 roots, starting with that G shape, alias to the D shape, A shape sandwich, other side, so it's 7L. It's a big 7L pattern. Okay, we're going to play that G shape right here, and we're going to start with the pattern. We don't have to play the defining string of that pattern like we have to do with the E shape here. You have to play the 7 root 2, then go into an S4L, and then finish up here with an S3L that's got shared. This is shared pattern. All right, but it's easy. It's easy when you're doing that. You just have to practice it a little bit and, you know, get it straight. It's like learning your lines or something, you know, if you're an actor. You know, you're not going to be expected to recall the same things at all times, but if you put a little time into it, it becomes easy. Here we go. We're going to start right into that S5L pattern. We did want to do that in G. So now we have to follow the pattern strictly. There's your F sharp. And remember, at the top of that S3L, we do a defining string shape pattern up there. Okay, we're back. So what I want to show you is what's going on with this pattern. If we just look at one side or the other side of this double pattern, we're going up in fourths. So we go up 5-6. Oh no, that's not true. That's not true. This is how they go up in fiddle. That's how they go up in guitar. I don't want to bring that chart up right now because it could get confusing. Let's stay on. This is the crooked fiddle ladder. And the way it works is you go caged horizontally and then up a fourth vertically. Now remember, the string note intervals in between the strings of the fiddle are fifths, but the string shape intervals, A is a string shape 5-6, G is a string shape 6-7, R. These scale fragments, they go up in fourths. So we're going to go caged and then up in a fourth. And so how do we do that easily? How do we remember that we're going to do that? And here's kind of the formula over here. We're going to skip every third letter in the word caged from whatever letter we start on. So caged is C-A-G-E-D. If we start on G, right, it's going to be G-E-D-C-A. If we start on A, it's A-G-E-D-C. If we start on E, it would be E-D-C-A-G. But we're going to skip every third letter in that caged word. Now that's when we're going up the crooked fiddle ladder. Okay, the ladder's kind of missing some rungs there. So it's kind of missing some rungs and it's kind of crooked. So that's why I named it the Crooked Fiddle Ladder. Now going down, we're going to be going down. When we go string to string, it's going to be a fifth. Okay. And it's not going to be caged then. It's the opposite of cage, which is a pentatonic scale. So we'll be going like, here's a pentatonic scale, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, if we start on E, it'll be E, G, A, C, D. If we start on G, it'll be G, A, C, D, E. But we're gonna skip every third one. So it will be, it'll go, if we're going down, okay, we're gonna go backwards, it'd be like D, E, then skip G to A. And here we're going to actually skip G. Oh, okay, this is wrong. This is only for going up. Oh, no, there's G. Sorry, it's not wrong. So we go D, E, skip G to A to C, skip what? The next one up from C is going back to D again, then E, G, okay, so, etc. So here's how that goes on the fiddle. So we start with, so let's look at our pattern again and employ, I know I'm not kind of showing you the pattern. So let's start on 5-6 here. We're going to go A, G, now we're going to spell caged. C, A, G, skip E, D, C, skip A, G, E, skip D. So you skip every third one going up. So it's A, G, skip E to D. Here's the D shape. See, my fingers are almost too small to make the interval. So I just kind of touch the string a little bit. So we got A to G. This is the G shape. And then to the D shape. By cage, we're going to share that the 3-4 with the C shape. Now we're going to skip the A shape and go to the G shape. Skip that third string, Andy. The G shape. That string's probably a little out of tune. Okay, was that C, then A. Okay, we should have that 7 root 2, the third C, then the A. Okay, that would be, we're I'll tell you what. Let's make sure, whoops, we're not making a mistake here. So let's take this out, and we're going to just do 4 strings at a time here. Okay, so now we're on the next. Now we're on the next one up. We have to find 7 now, or we're going to be in a different key. That's what it was. I wasn't on the wrong string. It was this. It wasn't working. Now we're going to have to play that. Play all 5 notes. Okay, I'm going to have to play all 5 notes. So it'd be 7. It'd be E shape, D shape. It's going to go E, D, skip C, A, G, skip E, D, C, skip D, okay, C, A, skip G, that kind of thing, all right, E, D, skip C, A, G, skip E, D, C, skip A, G, E, no D, so that's what it is, so it's 7 root 2, E, and then D, then A, then G, and then D, now we got it, then C, and then G shape, and E shape, sharing that 7 root. Okay, so starting way down the 7, just playing them up. Notice there's always an extra note there. So there you go. It actually works. And I think we're going to make it a short lesson because my wife's supposed to be home soon. And so as usual, keep playing, keep watching. If you want to try to put together the Facebook link and you have to apply for entrance into the group. Otherwise, just follow the YouTubes. Everything's right here. And I've got plenty of lessons planned in the future for fiddle and guitar. So until then, happy playing to y'all. Love that coffee.